Koa o ka Makea Ārera. Ārera te mimiti nui. Te tū erere ki tū oro. E tapere ko puku inu. E enua ko tumu te varovaro. E awate tai ko mango nui. Te ririanga vairua ki pō. E maunga te uta ko tapu tārangi. Arara ki te opunga. Koa o te papa. Te tumu enua. Kare au e neke. E tumu aki au no te enua. Aie koko!
Te koʻu, e maunga teia, te tāmarumaru ia i raro ake i te vaiianga a te ao tiaorangi. E maunga ngā tā a te koʻu i te piki, tāriva ua te airenga. Ka aere mātou ki uta i te ō o Takuvaʻine. E punāvai rongonui tō runga i a te koʻu. Te roto i teia punāvai, te ao kōrero taito. Ka tairia e mātou te teitei, rima ānere varu ngā uru mā varu mētera. Te mea mua ka ārawe atu au i a Pāpā Makiuti, e tumu kōrero me i Rarotonga mai.
Tērā e kapiki ana taki tumu tāna kapiki, me i tākaro ki tore aiwa. Te e a tākaro e tōna aitanga, north, e aramatangi. O tākaro, tērā e i tāpā. Auta, ko tiko, tērā maunga e o uri tōna waka. Te kou, no te kou. E, koe ua te maunga i Rarotonga ne. Koe e te rua te maunga i Rarotonga ne. E vai tōrunga e. Koe ura te maunga e, kare tōna wai e mate. Te tai maunga e vai tōna ko maunga rau. Ka mate rā ki tō maunga rau wai, i te tuatau maro. So e vai rei tōna, ara ake i ririnu ia. E vai tō te kou, te vai ua re tōna punāwe. Tua tō tamakianga rua. E ngā e tseki tera no te wai o te akaramai. Me aru mai te pai o Japani o Germany. E kua keru rātou ria jita e haratanga. Wārua, trench, keru rātou. Te wai rāra keru ngai tera mau. E ngā e pipinianga nā rātou i te akaramai, i tēne.
Tō tamarikianga e tanu na mātou te tarua, e te taro, e te utu, e te āmoa yuta e te o. Ere, very close ki te pēmaunga ia te koʻu ere pōro te rāngai.
Te Takuvaʻine, te o Takuvaʻine, riki uta.
No te mea ko, māra koe ko te rā tuatau, ko te tāngata rawa tā rātou kai. Ko te atutopau, the Māori people are very effective in being self-sufficient in everything. No te luxury o te tuatau ia ka nena wa ia e tō tātou i sāng. No rira te orang kōpapa te health, i maki e deteriorate te health. No te mea e te kai manufacture, process, the food out there.
Ka pehe te rāui. O rāui tō tātou ui tupuna i te ngāi i uta?
Well, the aitanga o te nā mua koe te marama e te tūtua rāui, ea te aitanga o te rāui. The aitanga o te rāui is the same as conservation. A tūtua papāo. Conservation is not a restriction of the use of resources. Conservation is the wise use of resources. Ko te aitanga tera o te tātou tuatua rāui, kare no te tapu i a koe to use the resource. No te karanga ki a koe, hey, take a break. Akaruke koe i tera resource ki a recover. So that there will be more to harvest. So ko te rāui, e apply e ana ki runga a certain crop. Kangatau te utu nā te katoa. So, me ka inaore ia ki rāui ia, because no te mātaro te rongotipu, te, then karanga ia, okay, rāui for a year.
Kia orana, te konei māo I te, te ngāi akamata o te ara ki a Maunga te Koʻu, pōpongi I tā pokipoki teia. Me mua, Sheena, me ka tika aka ara vei mai koe, ko ai koe.
Kia orana, my name is Sheena Vaitoru. I was born in New Zealand, but my family moved to Manihiki when I was 8 years old. My father's family is Manihiki and Rakahangan. My mum is Samoan, and I've been living in Rarotonga for the last 7 years. I just enjoy hiking. I haven't done all the mountains yet, but trying to get there. Like, once I know where they are, like, I'll try and do them all.
Mako. Here we are, kind of getting into the heart of the Takuvaʻine Valley, and we're here amongst all the taro tāwari. So this is the swampy kind of taro conditions that our tūpuna created when we arrived here. And it's mostly to try and increase productivity as much as possible. So our tūpuna saw that there were streams coming here, high quality water and nutrients coming from the mountains, but they wanted to figure out how can they maximize the taro growth. So they would identify where the boulders are and start stacking up rocks to create a wall, and then build stone aqueducts just like the Romans and the Greeks, and divert that across into their new taro patch or their new tāwari, and they build them in sets, so there might be 10 in one set, all connected by the same flow of water. And once that water gets to the bottom, they would then reconnect it back to the stream, so it just returns to where it came from. Here we are, we're actually at a site where we've got some rock carvings or petroglyphs. This is something we don't really see much in Rarotonga, and they're actually of European style ships or pa'i. They would have been such an interesting sight for our tūpuna to see when our Europeans arrived, and probably done with nails that were exchanged through trade. You know, we would have had fresh produce, pigs, everything that we could have traded with the Europeans. This valley has a strong connection to voyaging and, you know, those that came from the initial voyages. We're here in Anakitao, which is one of the branches of the Takuvaʻine Valley. Now I got to an area of one of our marais, which is also called Anakitao. There's Anakitao Iti and Anakitao Nui. I understand this is Anakitao Nui, and we know that the rocks up here and the larger boulders that create the walls expand up here another 10-15 metres. The thing with the marais up in the forest is that it doesn't take long for trees, tree roots, and even landslides. The marais don't do well over time. Rocks here, they're like a backrest where they can, our chiefs could have sat down and partaken in kava or whatever the ceremony was. But we're lucky that this rock still seems to be standing in the same place that it's been. There's other bigger flat rocks around here that look like they've fallen over, so we don't know where they were actually standing. This is the utu. This is one of our tūpuna foods. It's a type of banana. When it
grows out of the tree actually points to the sky. These are only found in high elevation areas, so they're known as mountain bananas as well. We're here on the ridge halfway towards Te Koʻu, so yeah, they're just growing here naturally, but they would have been planted by our tūpuna. They would have come up here, cleaned around them, and this would have been an important food source, you know, during times of famine or just when people are wanting to harvest utu for a special occasion. This is like one of our island delicacies. Yeah, we don't get a lot of it anymore, but we're fortunate here in Takuvaʻine Valley to have a few utu patches. Traditionally, they would have been looked after by different family lineages, but a lot of these utu plots up on the ridges now have been forgotten, so when we come across them, you know, it's actually good to see that they're still managing to grow on their own. But when we do, we try and clean around them and make sure that they've got some air to breathe, they're not being smothered by vines, and they'll be here for the future when we do come back. It takes about 18 months for it to grow to adult size, and then another 4 months for the bunch to actually ripen, compared to normal bananas, which might start fruiting within 9 months. Well worth the wait when you get to cook it in umu, taiakari, coconut cream, and oh, beautiful. Here we are, 588 meters above sea level, at the summit of Mount Te Koʻu. How did you find that, Sheena?
It was really challenging.
Yeah.
Yeah, we made it.
Yeah.
A whole lot of rope work.
Yeah, yeah.
A bit slippery.
Yeah.
Today.
Yeah, and yet it hasn't been raining for a while, so it's
So I had to come up when it was raining.
Yeah, cool.
Other than that, no, it was great.
Yeah. You talk about you go up hiking a bit. What are the mountains that you've hiked so far?
Just Raimaru,
yep.
The Needle,
yep.
Maunga,
yeah.
That's about it.
Yeah, cool.
Yeah, but I don't usually eat stuff that I pick and
drink from
the streams. That's like your experience.
Yeah.
But no, it's great.
Te te take o te maunga mātou, te maunga o te Koʻu. Ko teia te punāvai. Punāvai o Nunu e Nāna. Kōrero of this punāvai is that when they arrived, Karika actually brought one of his gods up here called Rangatira, the image of his god, and placed it here in the punāvai and appointed two guardians to take care of it. And they were Nunu and Nāna. And he also placed two fish within the punāvai, which he brought from the coast, one being the tapu tapu butterfly fish, and another fish, I'm not sure if that's a fish that we know of today. So two, you know, colourful fish would have floated around here in this very tapu pool. The water is still good for drinking, good for a swim, but we're not going to do that today. Yeah, just amazing to see one up here.
E ngā I mānea e te umeremere a uta I te o o Takuvaʻine. Ko teia te o e tai atu e koe ki uta I te take o te Koʻu. E maata te au kai Māori e tupu ana ki roto I teia ngāi. E maata katoa te au marae e te au repotaro taito tei tanu ia ki te taro, tei akatū ia e tō tātou ui tupuna. E ngāi tapu tētai I runga I teia maunga, ko ia ko te punāvai o Nunu e Nāna. Te vai nei rai te au ana, tei keru ia e tō tātou au vae ao Māori I te tuātou o te rua o te tamakianga o teia nei ao. Ka kama roiro I tātou ki a rauke I a tātou I te ākono e te pāruru atu I te o ngāi no te auki o Apopo. Thank you.